I am just so honored to be here with the three of you, Caitlyn Smith, Mags Duval, and Heather Morgan, precious, precious friends and women that I admire as musicians, as humans, and the founders of the Girls of Nashville. It is something to behold to get to see all three of you sitting right here before me. I just am so grateful. We're gonna get into the what is the Girls of Nashville, the community, and all of those things, but I wanna know the who first. So who are the Girls of Nashville?
The Girls of Nashville are all the incredible women of Nashville. It's a community of hit songwriters and artists and upcoming artists as well. And so we created this space, this event that we host a handful of times in a year that just highlights and gives a stage to the incredible women or girls of Nashville.
Amazing. There are many paths to making music in Nashville. No one's is really the same. But seeing all of these different women that you get to catch on stage at a Girls of Nashville show, there are 15 archetypes that night of how your career could go, or just an inkling of how it could go. And I do want to take a moment and lean into our environment here, because like this is the stage where, I mean, I've joined y'all. This is it. This is the room where, and I've sat as an audience member. And, you know, would you guys just like kind of set the scene of what it feels like? Because it is like a very, in some ways, a very feminine moment, and which is unusual for what, like, it often is a very rough and tumble country world that we all navigate. But these are very beautiful shows with a very specific feel and energy in the room. And I would love to hear you kind of set the scene for
Definitely.
People that have never been here.
I mean, we always talk about, and this is an aspect someone who attends the show doesn't get to see, but the backstage element's one of my favorite parts because, you know, Caitlin's touring, Heather's back and forth to Texas to see family, to all these places writing songs. I'm in LA too, and it's like, you know, we don't get to see each other all the time. We don't get to see our female friends in the industry all the time. A lot of times we're in different writing rooms doing different things, and we all get to curl our hair and put on makeup and like, you know,
help each other,
you know,
help
pick, yeah, like exactly. Pick the lipstick shades. And there's so just nice. So much that comes from that. That's so cool because we all get to catch up and have this time of getting ready for the show. That's this like really beautiful moment for everyone.
It just creates this community where you just feel like you're not alone. And it's in a city where you really can, where you're the one.
Yes.
It just, it's a warm hug. When, for an audience member, what you're seeing, what's different about this writer's round is we've got a live band that's led by Annie Clements.
She's incredible.
She plays bass for Maren Morris. And it's just an incredible band. And so all these women get to play their songs and have a backing band, which for a young artist who just moved to town, who can't afford to put together a band and do
might
a showcase or whatever, like it's wow, I get to play with a band. Like we're, you know, creating that opportunity for them, which is great. And then it's a writer's round, right? So there's 3 to 4 women across the stage, and we take turns sharing our stories and sharing our songs.
So we have this like woman problem in country music. We've talked about it a lot. I'm sure we'll talk more about it today in this interview. But sometimes I think we see like, you know, a Girls with Guitars, you know, radio show, or you see people gather women. And it feels like the only reason those people are gathered there are because they happen to be women.
Yeah.
Not because the talent is so extraordinary and the womanhood is, yes, it is a qualifying determiner of this show, but like this, the curation element of the show, I think, is really important because it's rather than a pat on the head of like, you little girls can come too. It's like, no, let me actually astound you with the talent that you don't know about, some of which is because of the way that our whole system is messed up. And some of it is because they're new or you just haven't heard of them yet or you didn't know, like, but I'd love to hear a little bit about that curation part or like the way that this work sort of dispels the like that thing.
The truth is that I think maybe we've been told there's only one spot. And so, like, but what we were realizing is that when we started listing all our favorite mm-hmm. females, that the list is so long. Mm-hmm. And there is so much talent mm-hmm. in this town.
So much.
And so, like, curating is actually, like, these shows are actually hard because it's like, we have 50 people that we want to have in this spot. And so, but it's like, it's just a testament to, like, the truth of, like, the talent well is massive.
It's
for
so
women.
True.
And they just, I would just love to make the spotlight a little bigger, right? Yes.
I mean, that's the thing too that's so cool about it is like, I think, you know, we said in the beginning, we would want to do this in someone's living room if we weren't doing it for an audience. Mm-hmm. Like, it's just such a fun time and we get to bring these women together and we get to share our stories and we get to celebrate each other. And it's like, you know, and it's very genuine. It's like our hearts are in this. And it's like every single time I leave feeling personally so encouraged and so supported and surrounded. And it's like, we want that to be conveyed to the audience too, that like this is a united front. We're together in this. We're like all supporting each other and like just celebrating each other's talent and success. And that's what's so special, because it's not like you'd think a show of that many women, it's like, okay, well, who's going to be the one that shine? And it really does feel like everyone shines, which is so special about it. And we try to make sure that it feels like, you know, every woman who plays holds their own and is true in who they are and like knows their worth and their talent. And like we help celebrate that.
I remember a very, very famous, successful female writer saying, not all that long ago, if you want to be a successful writer, write with men. You need to write with men. You need to have hits on men. And because our publishing companies are taking a huge risk on us.
Right.
It costs them money to sign us. And like they are looking for that return. And y'all have all had successful cuts with other people and also being artists yourselves. But I'm thinking about that, like, is that just good business? Would you pass that advice on to some? Do we not? How do we feel about a statement like that?
The first time we wrote together, Lindsay L., an artist we love, cut the song. And we had been in an all-female writer retreat. And that's one thing that we just said we wish would happen more, even in our own day-to-day with our calendars for songwriting. Do we just need more combinations with more females? There's plenty of female producers these days. And I think it's more of having that like conscious, like maybe we just have to be conscious of it and start pushing for that.
Nashville is a song town. And I think that the four of us all have enormous respect for the craft. Like a song, whether you're an artist or a songwriter, both, the song is the most powerful key. It will unlock any door. A great song will unlock any door that you think is between you and where you want to be. And it's just, I mean, it is all about that next great song. And so it's truly like, I mean, that is the currency. Go get it. Like, I think that's what I feel like I'm in this moment. I'm learning too of like, how do I want to position this town for the next generation? I think it's that. Like,
it's yes, song.
Definitely.
Yeah, the song.
It's so true. It really does come down to that too. I mean, in Nashville, and then even outside of Nashville and in different climates, it's like I work in LA too, and I've heard that so many times, the best song wins, you know, because when I was first there, also getting into the pop world of music, and the thing is I love lyrics, I love storytelling. I think Nashville,
that's the special thing about women writers too.
It's the best part of it is like you really get to tell your story, and we get to be in the rooms with artists and help them tell their stories and get to assist like people in explaining their lives and finding how small the world is and how many of us feel similar things. And there's such a beauty in that with songs. And it's just interesting to see like across the board the best songs cut through, you know, and a lot of the best songs happen to be written by women. You know?
Truth bomb.
I remember being in this room for an Early Girls of Nashville show. Maren Morris was in her before she was an artist days.
Yes.
Performing Second Wind. I was here with a producer friend.
Yes.
And I'm like, what the hell is happening?
Yeah, so
he's like,
amazing.
Apparently she like doesn't want to be an artist. But it's just like, that is what, that is like the journey that you can observe in the talent that we get to see displayed with Girls of Nashville. I feel like we have rightfully celebrated what you guys do, and I would like to do more of that too. But I am wondering, we've all been in this conversation for so, like, the problem of women in country music, the lack of opportunities, the lack of sort of access, you know, whether it's like radio and like we've talked about it. I'm sure you've all been interviewed about it ad nauseum. Like, what are we seeing? Are we seeing, where are you seeing change? However small, however meaningful, like where are you seeing change this many, nearly a decade into this conversation?
I think, well, part of it, like some of the girls that have played Girls of Nashville have started their own publishing companies, like Nicole Gallion and Hillary Lindsay doing that, like just getting in more leadership roles where they have some say-so, you know, in that way.
Definitely. And I think Marin and our bass player, Annie, actually met at one of the Girls of Nashville shows. And they've gone on tour together. So cool relationships have started from this where like women have gone on to write together or, you know, to become friends and have each other, to support each other. And I think even just seeing the way it's changed since I moved here when I was that young, it's really incredible. I felt super fortunate to have my first publisher be a powerful female, Beth Laird, and her husband, Luke Laird, too, is an amazing songwriter. They both really nurtured me in that time of my life, and I got to see a woman in that position really young. But even since, it's like so many women have started publishing companies or at higher roles now. It's like you definitely feel the energy changing a bit and it being recognized.
What can we do better?
I feel like we're working toward it, right? And we're starting here with just trying to create this community of supportive women, right? And I feel the Girls of Nashville, like, it expands beyond just songwriters and artists. Mm-hmm. Like, it's expanding to publicists and producers and and women at Apple. And, like there's women in, it's this community just growing, right?
Well, and you know what I'm thinking about too, and this is where I still have a lot of learning to do and I have a lot of work to do myself. But for so long, you know, us four white women could sit here and go, wow, it's so hard to get an equal shot in this business. And at that time, I wasn't even considering what it was like for Mickey Guyton to try to be, to try to have access and other black women that are coming onto the scene and people of color that are showing up in Nashville and wondering if there's a place for them too. And I think like how, tell us about how, I know y'all are being intentional about the work that you're doing. Like, what are we seeing as far as like a place to also support the women that don't just look like us?
Yeah. I mean, I think, and obviously I can only speak so much for someone who's not exactly in our situations, but I think representation is so important. Mm-hmm. So much change is inspired by representation. And it's like when, you know, young women can see someone doing something, it's real to them. Mm-hmm. So it's like, I can do that because I'm seeing it being done. And it almost makes me get emotional to think about because, you know, in so many ways, I can imagine just like we felt like we're not really seeing many women on stage. Can we do this? You know, a young black woman seeing Mickey Guyton persevere. And we're friends and we all follow her too. And she shares sometimes just the hate she has to face outside of the industry. And it's, I mean, she is so strong and so talented. And I think she's paving the way for so many young women. And just seeing her is going to instill the belief that it's possible for them, yeah. You know, and for all of us to be able to help create opportunities for that representation to be normalized is so important.
And I think it is, too, about realizing that as much as I feel like it's stacked against me moving over and sharing and making room because I actually do have an easier shot than some of my sisters, you know. And so I think it's exciting to see y'all doing the same on this stage. Caitlyn, we need to talk a little bit about this album.
Okay.
High and Low, it's coming soon.
High and Low is coming soon. I'm so excited. I can't even wait. I've spent the last year like pouring my heart, being in the studio and self-producing a record for the first time, which I'm very, I'm like shaking talking about it. Because it's something like I felt like music. We talked about this the other day, like Music was kind of mystified a little bit for me as a woman, as a young girl moving to this town. And I almost felt like those roles are reserved for dudes.
The production side.
The production side, right? And so, like, but I've always been like, but what? What? But I'm curious about it. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, and this, I think, all goes hand in hand with the things we've been talking about today is like, I just felt like, you know what? What's the worst that can happen? Let's produce this record. Let's try it. I brought along Gina Johnson, like some of the most incredible ears in Nashville to engineer the album. She's worked on Stapleton and Ace Feldman. And so, you know, pour my heart and soul into this album. It will be released in a couple parts this year. But I'm really proud of it.
I can't wait to get my ears on
that. I think April 8th is the date. So
April 8th.
Yeah,
we're ready for it.